I pay for a lot of app subscriptions, but I think they're worth it. So in this video, I'm going to tell you every app that I actually pay for and the subscriptions I came across and canceled while making this video. And by the way, thanks to everyone who voted in the poll what video I should make. I still want to make my dual Mac workflow video where I'm going to talk about how I keep my Mac Studio and MacBook Air in sync and do all my work across both. But YouTube wanted to hear every app subscription I pay for, and apparently so did Threads, so we're doing it. Unsurprisingly, Mastodon wanted to see my dual Mac workflow, but get subscribed because I'm still going to do that video too. All right, I'm going to start this video at the top with a shortcut, because there actually is a shortcut which will jump you directly to all the app subscriptions you pay for through your Apple ID, and you can download the shortcut in the video description below. It's a one-step shortcut, open URL, and that's the URL scheme for opening the Settings app directly to your subscriptions. So first up, yes, I use AppleCare on pretty much all my products. Everything but my Mac Studio, I think, has AppleCare, and this includes my kids' Apple Watches and iPads, so yeah, a bunch of AppleCare subscriptions. We're just going to blow right past those. I do pay for Apple One, the premier level, and I also pay for additional iCloud storage. So I get 8 terabytes total of iCloud storage. And as you can see, I'm over halfway there. But I use Apple Music, Apple News Plus. I share this with 5 other people in the family. So Apple One is worth it for me. Now this next one, not necessary for everybody, but Apple Podcast Connect. If you want to offer paid subscriptions or paid content directly in Apple Podcasts, you actually have to pay $20 a year to have access to those tools. That's why if you listen or watch my tech podcast with Jason Aten, Primary Technology, you can subscribe directly here in Apple Podcasts, which you get access to our Monday through Friday daily tech show, our unedited feed, and you also get an ad-free version and bonus episodes of the podcast. We offer all of that through Apple Podcast subscriptions, and we pay $20 a year to be able to do that. Next, I've talked about Bear a ton of times. It is my go-to note-taking app of choice. I use it here on my Mac, my iPhone, my iPad, and it just has so many features that are worthwhile to me. I actually did an entire video on why I use Bear Notes and why it's worthwhile, so you can watch that up here. Next, it's one of my favorite movie apps. Yes, I pay for CallSheet, subscribe to the annual plan at $9. But I really love movies. I love being able to look information up, and CallSheet has all of that information, plus fun Easter eggs, like if I tap on the runtime of a movie, it'll tell me if I start watching it right now, what time the movie will end. Plus it has quick links to things like Letterboxd or Parental Guidance. You have all the cast. Also got TV shows here as well. And what I really like is when you're watching an older movie, let's say you're watching one of my favorites, Gladiator, you can actually see the age of the actor when they were in the movie. So you can see Russell Crowe was 36 when he was in the movie and he's 61 now. You can also go into individual actors, lots of information there, plus their filmography. And you don't get all those ads. You can pin things to your homepage if you'd like. And yes, CallSheet has shortcuts actions as well. At $9 a year, yeah, absolutely worth it. Yes, I pay for ChatGPT monthly, ChatGPT Plus. I use it in a bunch of shortcuts. For a lot of my shortcuts, like this one where I format my Primary Technology show notes, I use the Ask AI action. And here I actually put in my OpenAI API key, because this is way more reliable than just the straight ChatGPT action. Now, once iOS 26 and macOS Tahoe comes out this fall and I have access to the Apple Intelligence Model action, I might switch to that and stop paying for ChatGPT, but I need to see how good it is with things like video title and descriptions, podcast title and descriptions, and more. So this $20 is for ChatGPT Plus, which I also use in the Mac app, but I also pay for API access directly through OpenAI. Next, I was paying for Click for Sonos. It's a great app for controlling your Sonos speakers from your Mac or your iPhone. It's a great third-party app for controlling your entire Sonos home theater system. And if you didn't like the Sonos app update, this is a great option. You even see battery levels for things like the Sonos Move. I really do love the app, especially for controlling it via the Mac. I just don't end up controlling my Sonos system very often. I usually shout to HomePods, and the Sonoses are connected to TVs for the most part. Next, Croissant, $20 a year subscription, 100% worth it. As I'm trying to manage all the different social networks, Croissant makes it super easy to post to Blue Sky, Mastodon, and Threads all at the same time. Not only that, but I also really like that when I attach photos to a post, I can add the alt text quickly here, and it's gonna send that alt text to all three of those platforms. And I really like being able to offer that, but it's tedious if you have to copy and paste that and a post across all the networks. So whenever I post to any of those networks, I do it from the Croissant app. And if I'm gonna go post over on X, I do have to copy and paste it manually over there. Next, Fantastical is my calendar app of choice. It is a $10 a month subscription, but this is for the family plan. My wife shares this. We both use Fantastical. I use it everywhere, here on my Mac, my iPhone, my iPad. I love being able to create calendar sets, and then these integrate with focus modes on my iOS devices and my Mac. Plus, you can do things like hide an event but not delete it from your calendar. And just to show you real quick, if you go into a focus mode, like my filming focus mode, or I have one for evening and one for weekends, you'll see focus filters, fantastic Cal as an option, and then you can choose the calendar set that you want to be active during that focus mode. I did a whole video about why I pay for fantastic Cal as well and all the cool features, so I'll link that one above and down in the description. Now, if you fly, Flighty is the only app you need. It is amazing for tracking your flights, for seeing delays, route information, but I don't fly very often, so I typically will pay for it and then cancel it whenever I don't need it. But if you travel often, Flighty is the app to get. Next, Fourscore, it's $15 a year, but Fourscore is the best digital sheet music app. I absolutely love it. I don't have reason to use it as much anymore, but my wife uses it for her flute playing and in the orchestra. And if I ever have a reason to use sheet music, I love Fourscore on my iPad. You can turn pages just by blinking or nodding your head at your device. It's wild. Best sheet music app you can get. ShareShot, $15 a year. Again, 100% worth it. I love ShareShot because it lives in the control center and I can quickly frame my screenshot. So I just took a screenshot, I'll swipe down to control center, hit the ShareShot action, and now that quickly I've framed the screenshot, nice background, and I can save this to my camera roll. You can also use ShareShot on the Mac and the iPad. You can also edit it with different gradients in the background. It's my favorite app for framing your screenshots. Well worth the $15 a year. Now I was paying for GoodNotes for PDF management on the iPad, but now that we have the Preview app, I actually canceled that while I was making this video. So no more GoodNotes for now. I'll see if I can get along with just the Preview app. Now, I'm already paying for Apple Premier Bundle, where you get some iCloud storage, but I needed that 8 terabytes to share with the family, and so this is for the additional 6 terabyte storage, which is on top of the Apple Premier Bundle. You can see all the plans. There is one more level I can upgrade to. I don't need to do it just yet, but nice to know I have a little bit of breathing room. Yeah, I pay for Meta Verified. I don't know if it's worth it. Maybe it's a vanity metric. Maybe I'm lying to myself thinking that I will get more reach on Instagram, which if you don't already follow me, that's my username. You should go follow me on Instagram. I'm trying to do more stories. But yeah, I pay for Meta Verified. I don't know if that's worth it. Now, this one right here. Listen, I pay for Apple Music. I understand that iCloud Music Library supposedly syncs all the tracks that don't match directly in Apple Music, that your music is somehow safe in the cloud, and Apple Music has all those files as well. I do not trust that I can cancel iTunes Match. Here's why. I have a bunch of tracks saved in Apple Music that are recordings I made during college and after of my different performances, whether it was jazz band or orchestra, and I know iTunes Match has all of these tracks somewhere in the cloud, so I can download them on my other devices. I know I should probably back all these up to my network-attached storage and have them saved elsewhere, but I haven't done that yet, and so I'm just going to keep paying for iTunes Match. It's $25 a year. As long as they offer it, I will continue to pay for it. Also because I think if I ever cancel Apple Music or my Apple One Premier Bundle, I think still having iTunes Match will keep these tracks in the cloud, but not chancing it. I'm keeping it. Of the 18 different social media platforms, I am also on Mastodon, and Ivory is just the best app for browsing Mastodon. It's from the makers of Tweetbot, if you use that app. So yeah, I use Ivory on my iPhone, my Mac, my iPad. It's the best. I do have one content blocker I pay for, which is Magic Lasso, $30 a year. Works pretty well. I use it in Safari. I am a Wordle and Connections person, so I pay for the New York Times app because it's just a better experience, no ads. I'm paying for Peacock because my wife and I are watching the last season of The Voice, and as soon as we finish that finale, I'm canceling that. But nice that I could have it in my Apple subscription, so it's easy to cancel. I was paying for Perplexity just because I did a video comparing it to the voice assistant on iPhone. I'll link that video above. It did really well because it can actually integrate with Apple Music, reminders, and calendar events. But I'm not using it anymore, so I canceled that as I was making this video. I've talked about Pushcuts before. Pushcuts is a great app for creating push notifications, especially for smart home devices or even battery alerts on your Apple devices. But I have multiple Pushcuts, like one if my mini fridge is left open outside. I have a contact sensor on that, and I have an automation runs that if it's left open, then I get a push notification. If my iPad falls below 75% battery or if it charges above 80%, I get push notifications for that. So I just love being able to do this. You use it directly with shortcuts. I did a whole video on it. I'll link it above as well. Oh, apparently I pay for 1Password as well, but that's not in-app subscriptions. That's here. I use iCloud passwords by default and on all my devices, but I pay for the family plan and I just like having that little bit of redundancies. I use Reader for reading all my RSS news and feeds, and the new app was nicely designed, but I still prefer the classic Reader app. So I'm still rocking R-E-E-D-R, just the regular Reader app for catching up on all my news. Syncs the feeds over iCloud for my Mac and my iPad. I like the designs, so I stick with that Reader, and I don't pay for this one anymore. Screens is my VNC app, which I actually used in my Mac Mini video, showing how I also have a bunch of workflows there. I'll link it above or down in the description if I ran out of flags. But I love the Screens app. I have it on my Mac Studio and the Mac Mini where I have some workflows going. I can control the Mac right here from my iPhone or iPad, and it works remotely anywhere I have internet access. $25 a year, very worth it. Showcase was an app I recently discovered and showed it off in my 30 apps for summer video. Links there and below. I just love the design of this app. You can see how long it is till the next movie you want to see or the next episode of the TV show you want to watch. You can go over and see what movies are out right now. You can mark them as watched. I plan to see Superman this weekend. It's just a beautifully designed app, and there were some movies I was interested in coming soon, and I like being able to see it here. Also has a nice widget that you can see the upcoming movies right on your home screen. I've talked about Sofa before, did a whole video on it, I'll link that as well. But Sofa is where I keep track of movies I want to watch, movies I have watched, and also I keep track of my books read or books I want to read, and it actually now has podcasts as well. But you can also create smart lists, and so I actually have a list here where I tag movies as family. So these are movies I want us all to watch as a family. And then I also have just movies I want to watch in general. This might be just for me and my spouse. And so you can create those smart lists. And I also keep track of the books that I have read here in Sofa. I really love keeping track of them here. Has all the nice imagery, automatically populates when you add a book to Sofa. So when it comes to just managing books, movies, TV shows that I want to watch or have watched, I love Sofa for all of that. Transcriptionist, this is $20 a year. It is a great app. It uses the OpenAI models, but it's by the same developer who makes Ferrite, the app I use to edit the audio version of my podcast. And you can go into the transcriptionist settings, choose what AI brain you want to use to transcribe, and then you can export in all the different formats, whether it's SRT for subtitles, plain text. I use transcriptionist every time I make a video, I transcribe it, and then send the transcript to ChatGPT and ask it for titles, descriptions, and tag ideas. And Transcriptionist is on iPad and iPhone. So if you want to be able to quickly transcribe audio files on your mobile device, you can do that with the Transcriptionist app on iPhone and iPad too. Love the app, well designed, works really well. Highly recommend. So VidAngel, that's a service where you can actually filter things out of movies like profanity or nudity. And when we watch some movies with the kids, I will filter some things out. You don't get the full resolution of the movie. You also don't get things like the Dolby Atmos audio track. So it's a worse viewing experience. But my kids range in age from 9 to 16. And so being able to watch a movie all together, but make it appropriate for all the ages, that's what I use VidAngel for. WatchSmith, that's made by underscore David Smith for custom complications on the watch. He also makes the great WidgetSmith app, which I use on my phone. And finally, I have one subscription to an X account, and it's basic Apple guy. I like supporting him. See, that's his pin right there. So those are all the app subscriptions I have on my phone. If you have one that you feel is super worth it, I'd love to hear about it. I can do another app roundup video coming soon. So get subscribed, hit that like button. Plus, lots of videos on iOS 26, macOS Tahoe, and iPadOS 26 are coming as the public betas are released very soon. Also, if you think there's a subscription that's just totally not worth it that I'm still paying for, let me know down in the comments. I'll put two videos up here. This is my iPadOS 26 video. And if you're into shortcuts and want to see what I did with the Siri bot shortcut, basically using the Apple intelligence actions, that video is right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.